Welcome back to Latest News with me, Yael Breuer. Now for our update with Elif Kose and her Rottingdean boutique. She came into the studio to speak to Bill Smith.
I'm with Elif Kose, who runs one of the main boutiques on the South Coast. Well done, Elif, on all your success. You've made a film?
Thank you. Yes, we have, only very recently, about my life.
Can we watch it?
Of course, let's do that.
Let's watch it.
When people see me now, they see a happily married, successful businesswoman with the most beautiful baby boy. But deep inside me is still the frightened child who grew up in Turkey. The young girl who suffered the frustration and oppression of growing up in a strict Muslim family. The terror of the abuse I was subjected to still lingers. Its icy fingers can still reach out and touch me. Even now, I can still feel the fear, the frustration, and yes, the anger from that part of my life. It seems a lifetime ago now. I had decided to escape Turkey and all that went with that life by coming to England to be an au pair. My new life started in the arrival hall at Heathrow, with just a single suitcase to carry my whole world and just £265 in my pocket. Looking back, I find it hard to believe I survived the loneliness. I spoke no English, and the isolation I felt in those first few months could so easily force me to give in and go back. But I made myself look forward. I visualized my dreams and I set myself goals. Tiny goals to start with. Learn a new word, make a new friend, get through a day without crying or being afraid. I gave myself permission to be proud of myself, permission to feel worthy of happiness, permission to feel I deserve more from life. And slowly, I overcame obstacles and challenges. I met the love of my life, then came the birth of our beautiful boy, and the sheer and utter joy of motherhood. Everything I dreamt for was in place, and I felt truly and deeply happy. How little did I know that it could all be ripped apart again so quickly. Less than 6 weeks after the birth of my son, my dad suddenly died. My husband was working long hours. I was an exhausted new mom, and once again felt so alone, scared, and full of self-doubt. Then one day, I looked through my tears into the eyes of my tiny baby. I saw my love, my hopes, and my dreams reflected there. And in that moment, I knew I could survive the test, rise to the challenge, and achieve even more. This is my story, but it is not the end, just the beginning of a new chapter with new goals and overwhelming desire to inspire and empower others to believe in themselves. Most of all, I want to remind everyone that their past does not define their future.
So that's a great film. It tells about your early life, a difficult start in life, but your success now. A lot of women will be thinking, that's great, I would like to do that. What's your advice to them?
Well, that's the whole reason behind doing this film, is to actually empower those women out there who feel less fortunate and they think there will be luck coming to get them out of their adversity. And I'd like to give them the light, if it makes sense.
Well, you've done well, you've won lots of awards, but you had a very difficult start in life, didn't you?
Mm.
You come from Turkey. Tell me a little bit about your early life.
Where I come from, it's a very modern town and a lot of people in working life, and women are out there in public, but in deep down, there's always, I feel women always feeling they can't do certain things. I brought up as a woman who can't wear what she wants to wear, she can't really talk what she wants to talk because I'm a woman. So I come from that background, and that made me feel very angry in a way. I am one of three and I've got two brothers. I used to be very good at acting, singing. I wanted to be part of all those school trips and everything, but I wasn't allowed to do it because I was a daughter. Whereas my brother was allowed to do anything he liked because...
So essentially you came to Brighton, city of sanctuary, to be free as a woman.
Well,
to
yeah.
To be able to do what you want to do.
It was just my kind of escape plan to just to live my life the way I wanted to live. I didn't want to wait for luck to turn up because it was not happening. What I'm hoping with my video is to give a bit of hope to those women, especially if this is their not home. I made this country my home. I worked very hard at my business and I made incredible friends, and it gave me strength to talk about something that I kept quiet for many, many years. Mm.
So anyway, Elif Kose Boutique, it's in Rottingdean, it's an award-winning boutique. This is Elif, she's going to make some more films about her life.
Yeah.
And hopefully empower women and men as well.
The Naked Bike Ride came to town last month and Mike Mendoza takes a look back at the highlights. Here is his report.
That time of year again where the Naked Bike Ride takes the streets of Brighton and Hove. The first stop is going to be at Hove Lawns, and we'll be talking to some of the people involved with the bike ride very soon. Richard, you owned the Lawns Cafe for a long time now.
I did.
How's the Naked Bike Ride affect you?
Not a great deal, to be quite honest. I think some people come down to have a look and watch them come in, but by and large we don't see many of them as customers. We do see a few come around, mm-hmm. which is always interesting, but it's certainly not a hindrance. It doesn't send people away, so if it's a nice day we'll be busy, but probably busier for them being here a little bit anyway. But
are they exhibitionists, or do you think they're doing it for a good cause?
A bit of both, I think. There are certainly an exhibitionist element, but most of them, I think, and probably all of them, are doing it for the cause as well.
Mm-hmm.
But there are certainly some that are quite proud of their credentials.
Possibly the biggest ride I've seen for many years, and I've been to probably most of them since this ride began. Something else taken off, and the weather's not brilliant, so it's absolutely fantastic. There should be such a massive turnout. Hello, this is the first time you've seen this?
Yeah.
You like?
Yeah.
You're shocked?
Yeah.
You're shocked?
I liked it. It's very, it's quite liberated.
Yeah, yeah. You do it next year.
I feel like I've just been resurrected.
Why do you do this?
For the fun of it.
What?
For the fun of it.
Fun of it, yeah.
Yeah.
See, a lot of people say exhibitionism is part of it. Would you say it's that, or are you actually trying to get a message across?
No, we're not trying to get a message across. No, we're not into this,
Save the planet.
Save the planet, save cyclists and all this sort of stuff, you know.
What makes you do it every year?
What, why?
Yeah.
Well, the first time it was purely by accident. I wondered what was going on. I asked them what they were doing. I said, you're doing the Naked Bike Ride for various reasons. And I thought, no, I don't think so, not in my own town.
Mm-hmm.
And gradually I got more used to the idea.
How do you do this?
I'm an avid cyclist, and I heard about it and thought, why not? I was a little bit nervous the first time I did it. And then the sense of freedom and sort of unity that it engenders, I just, yeah, definitely going to do it for life, I think.
Well, looking around you, you're incredibly popular today. is this normal?
No, normally I have less headgear and more clothes.
Uh-huh. Lovely. So you can't be mistaken for a guy, though?
No. Yeah.
Well, Well, that's the Naked Bike Ride for yet another year. 2019 is done and dusted. Looking forward to 2020. This is Mike Mendoza for latest TV news.
That's it for tonight. We'll be back tomorrow evening with more of your local stories. Don't forget to follow Latest TV on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram. And you can watch our news items again at thelatest.co.uk. Join us tonight for The Vote with Mark Walker for a more in-depth look at your local news stories. Good night. Goodbye.